I was having my fascination for the liquid engine, liquid systems. But nobody believed that a liquid propulsion system can be made, leave alone its usefulness, leave alone its versatility, leave alone its capability, nothing. It's not possible. Simply because you don't have the propellant, you don't have the oxidizer, you don't have the fuel, you don't have the high temperature materials, you have nothing. So you can do nothing with that. But something has to be done. So my only job was to keep on telling wherever the policy making body or the meetings are there, you keep on saying that a liquid must be made, a liquid must be made. So it became a song, and some people used to run away from me when I started going nearer to them saying, yes, yes, we have had enough of your liquid. So then, you know, it became a joke actually. Excepting Professor Sarabhai, when I got admission in the Princeton, I was going in the same aircraft, Annapurna. Sarabhai was also coming in the same aircraft. So he asked me, and then I told him, actually, I got admission in the solid propulsion with Professor Summerfield, Martin Summerfield, a name which everybody must be knowing. He's a well-known name for the solid propellant system. But I have no interest in going for the solid propellant. I wanted to go to liquid propulsion. So I said, this, I'm going. He said, you are going to Summerfield. I said, no, sir, I'm going to Croco, Louis Croco. But your admission is only, no, 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 I will go and manage there. Actually, I didn't know a damn about how to manage, what to manage, where to talk, nothing. I'm going there with a hope that I will manage. Anyway, the management part of it, I don't want to elaborate because it will sometimes will be used by some of you in a different way. So let me tell you, I just went there and talked to Professor Summerfield with pleasantries. In fact, there is a criteria called Summerfield effect. They are very interesting criteria. So I praised. And then I said that, sir, please help me to get me into. Actually, depending upon the vacancies only, they allot the. Then he said, go and talk to Professor Luigi Croco. If he's interested, he will take you. Now, he was a very old person, and I happened to read his one of the so-called stability theorem, Croco's theorem. It is known as Croco's theorem. Even today, it is a very, very valid theorem. And only thing is, many people use only the result of it, and nobody bothers to understand how the hell it was derived or how the hell it was found out. But I unfortunately or fortunately happened to read the whole thing. So I went and told him that, sir, he said very simple language. He said, my wife is not well. She is bedridden. I can't come to the college. So I can't help you. I said, I'll come to the house. No, no, but I am. Anyway, finally, what he said, he looked at my grades and he looked at my project work, all the things. But very difficult for him to say no. But he said, let us do an experiment. Let us work for about a month. Let us see how it goes. But please understand, you have to come to my house every time whenever you want to go. I won't come to the office, etc. Anyway, to my satisfaction, I was successful in managing my trip to Sarabhai, I mean, change over to the liquid. Incidentally, in ISRO, we never had a liquid rocket, nothing. But in Princeton, you have everything. So I was asked to work. I was also given a NASA fellowship. I applied for it and I got it. And that particular project was instability of one of the existing engines. The existing engine is the lunar module, which was supposed to lift off from the moon's surface with Neil Armstrong. Now, I was excited because that's a great engine, and it is already flying. But what is there to look at it? Anyway, I started that, and to my shock, I found that the engine is having a very low margin of safety, I mean, stability margin. I did not know what to do. Should I go and tell Professor Croco that this engine which you are successfully flying has less margin of safety or stability? Then I checked and checked. I had one Russian engineer, Shrivansky. You know, he is actually a postdoctoral fellow, but he has joined on a postgraduate program here under the Summerfield collaboration. And we became friends. Some of the Russians will become a good friend of you because they think that you are a closest friend to them. And he is the one who who helped me in a way, saying that you are right, you go and tell your Professor Croco that this is having less margin of safety. That is one contribution. Second contribution is, he talked about an engine called KVD-1. This KVD-1 engine is a cryogenic engine. As you know that both cryogenic as well as the air storable, both are liquid only. So he said that we have the highest specific impulse, namely 462 seconds, which in all stretch of imagination, it was not a published work. So I have not read that particular availability, particular engine. So I asked him, are you joking? He said, yes, it is available. Then why are you not using it? No, we wanted to close it and they have locked up. We didn't want to make it. But I couldn't sleep because the published literature in American side says 440 odd seconds only. This is much more than 20 seconds more than that. Anyway, that I'll come back later. So this particular incident with which I was talking to Sarabhai, he used to visit quite often. Incidentally, Sarabhai is from MIT and he had very good relations with the American. In fact, he has such a powerful relation. Arnold Fredkin, who passed away very recently, he was somebody big in NASA. And Sarabhai used to call him, hey, how are you? In that kind of a relation. So Sarabhai, first time coming to know that there are missiles which are employing liquid propulsion systems. He was under the impression that almost all the missiles are using only the solid propulsion systems. Anyway, so that particular story, now why I am saying this is that I told you earlier that Sarabhai wanted you to become a powerful person. So he became really excited, and then he said, the first encouragement with a meaningful approach from the powerful person in the organization comes through this knowledge. So I completed my job, and then I came back to India. To my unfortunate situation, I came back, and within a year, Sarabhai passed away. So the only encouragement which I had to do something on liquid is also gone. And Professor Dhawan came, again, usual story. And Professor Dhawan somehow, you know, he immediately understood the merit of the liquid system. So he said, all right, let us do something. And some of the very big names in ISRO, I don't want to mention the names, none of them were very happy about the development of the liquid systems, barring the second chairman, that is Professor Dhawan. And Professor Dhawan's conviction was so high. Whenever he wants to support me, see, in ISRO, the working situation is that you should have a project, you should have under the project a manpower, then the funding, and then, you know, that kind of a system. I didn't have a project, I didn't have manpower, I didn't have the funding. So how can you? Then even in the chairman's discretionary funds, he will give some exploratory work, half a crore, 1 crore, something like that. Support was not very much there. With the little money, I got fed up. I told him, either you give me a meaningful budget or stop giving me that paltry sum, I don't need it. But then, Professor Dhawan told me one important point, saying that without investing much of money, is there a way to do the liquid system? I said, what do you mean? No, I mean, I'm not in a position to give a lot of money, but I think you should do the liquid systems. You are all laughing. I also couldn't help it. At that time, one person whom you may know is Mr. T.N. Seshan. He was our director of administration. So he was more or less like my guru, whom I liked very much, or probably he also liked me, I don't know for what reason. So I went and told him, this is what Dhawan says. But then he asked, what did he say? I said, how is it possible? No, you should say yes. I said, how are you going to do it? You will find. You don't close the door by saying no. You say yes. Maybe some way will come.